Hello friends, welcome to the ASUS Technical Campus. In previous lecture, we have completed our topic, that is drawing signal flow graph from system equation. Now today we will see the our next topic, that is method to draw signal flow graph from block diagram. In previous lecture we have drawn the signal flow graph from given system equation. Now today we are going to see the drawing signal flow graph from block diagram. Now let's see the what are the steps. We know that in block diagram consists of blocks, summing point, takeoff point, while signal flow graph consists of only nodes and branches. So in case of system equation, we have seen that the variables are considered as a node. So in block diagram, each summing point, summing block and takeoff point are considered as a separate node. So first step is represent each summing block and takeoff point as separate node. Means in this case, the each summing block and takeoff point are represented as a node. Now next is connect them by branches instead of blocks. What is step 2? Connect them branches instead of blocks. Now next is step 3 is block transfer function is represented as a branch gain. In system equation we have seen that constant of that variable is represented as a branch gain, but here block transfer function, in case of block diagram, block transfer function is represented as a branch gain. Transfer function is represented as branch gain. And lastly, step 4 is show input and output node separately with branch gain as a 1. Show input and output nodes separately with branch gain as a 1. In this, input and output node are represented by the branch gain 1. So these are the steps to draw the signal flow graph from given block diagram. Now we will see the example, then you will get clear idea about that. So let's take first example, that is convert the given block diagram to a signal flow graph. So here one block diagram is given, that is R of S, summing point, G of S, C of S, after that H of S, so this is one block diagram and we have to draw the signal flow graph for this block diagram. So what is our first step? Represent each summing block and take a point as a separate node. Here this is summing block and this is takeoff point. We have to mark it as a separate node. So and we have seen that input and output nodes are separately represented with branch gain 1. So here R of S means one input node, that is R of S. After that summing block, so it is represented as a separate node, so we represent as a S1 as it is summing block. After that here when it is present, takeoff point, so we will represent as a T1, and lastly is a C of S, so we will represent as a C of S. So first step is mark the nodes. After that we have seen that block transfer function is represented as a branch gain. Whatever value are present inside the block, it is represented as a branch gain. So connect each node by branches instead of blocks. So instead of blocks, we have connected them with branches. After that, what is next step? Transfer function is represented as a branch gain. So we have seen for input and output, branch gain is 1. So here input node is present, so that branch gain is 1. Here in output node is present, for that branch gain is 1. Now after that, here in middle, before takeoff point, G of S transfer function is present. So we will represent as a G as a transfer gain. Now after that, from this takeoff point to this summing point, one block is present, so we represent it as it is gain, but it is negative. Here negative sign is present, so we will mark it as a minus H. This is very simple of drawing signal flow graph from block diagram. So it is very simple. First note down the nodes, input node, output node, or whatever summing a block or takeoff point are present, mark as a node. After that, connect them with branches instead of blocks. After that, write the transfer function as the branch gain. So that's why we have written this minus H. Minus is H is come here because here feedback is negative. So this is the method of drawing block signal flow graph from block diagram. Now we will see one more example. Here one another block diagram is given, that is R of S summing point G1 G2, after that summing point from here to G2, one feedback loop is present. After that from G1 to this one feedback loop is present. After that negative sign, negative feedback. After that G3 block. After that C of S, one closed loop is there, gain is not there, means its gain will be 1 minus. So this is a block diagram and we have to draw signal flow graph of this block diagram. So first step is mark the node. So first is input node, that is R of S. After that first summing point is present, so S1. After that here second summing point is present, so second node S2. After that here before summing point, one takeoff point is there. Before summing point, this takeoff point is present, so mark this as a T1. Before that summing, before that takeoff point, another one takeoff point is present. So mark it as a T1 and it is T2. And lastly, our output node, that is C of S. So now next step is connect them with branches instead of blocks. So here from input to first summing point, from first summing point to first takeoff point, so its gain is here G1. So it is mark over here, and gain of input node is 1. So mark here. After that, from T1 to T2, G2 block is there. So G2 gain will present from T1 to T2. After that, from T2 summing point, no gain, connect as it is. After that, here G4 block is present from takeoff point T1 to summing point S2. Takeoff point T1 to summing point T1 with again G4. So mark it over G4. After that, S2 to here another takeoff point is present, that is T3. Before output C of S, another takeoff point is present, that is T3. So from S2 to T3, one block is present, so mark as a G3, and after that takeoff point to output, so mark it as a 1. After that, from this takeoff point, that is T2 to summing point S1, T2 summing point S1, negative feedback is present, that is minus H1, and after that, from this takeoff point to summing point T3 to S2, one feedback loop is present, gain is not there, means gain is 1, so T3 to S2 minus 1. So this is the method of drawing signal flow graph from block diagram. So it is very easy. First, mark all summing point and takeoff point, input node and output node as a node. Connect them with branches. And after connecting with branches, simply mark whatever value present inside the block as a branch gain. So this is very simple method of drawing signal flow graph from the block diagram. Now, in next lecture, we will see some important definitions related to signal flow graph, which will be very, very useful while obtaining transfer function from signal flow graph. So it is very important topic, that is obtaining transfer function from signal flow graph. In exam, you have at least minimum one example on this. So this is very important topic. If you practice more, then you will be familiar with this example, and you can quickly solve this example. So you need more practice for this example. Thank you.